My name's Robert TerBerg. I'm with Thurber Engineering Limited. It's an environmental and geotech engineering consultancy, and I'm a senior hydrogeologist. So I deal with problems to do with groundwater and soil, mostly from a contamination point of view, but also from a groundwater supply point of view. There's a lot of project management skills, so putting together the various components of an investigation. So there's you need a driller, you need a lab, and you need to have somebody that can actually go out and do the work, and then your own reporting time. And then now what I do is just a broad range of investigations. So I do environmental investigations, you know, land recycling and environmental cleanup, groundwater supply investigations, so people that want to set up subdivisions, you know, farms or, you know, industrial subdivisions, so they want to put in a little warehouse or a factory or something, and they need a water well, or they need a septic field assessment, that kind of thing. So I do those. Then there's towns, villages. They have lagoons for waste lagoons or landfills, and those liners, those require permeability assessments to make sure that they're tight, you know, and they won't leak. So I do a lot of permeability barrier assessments. And sometimes you get a site that's so badly polluted, the only way to deal with it is to contain it. So they put in a grout barrier around the site, and then that has to be tested too. And then there's remediation, site remediation. So that's where it becomes economic to actually dig up and haul away the contamination. Landfill costs are really cheap in Alberta, so that actually is very often the alternative. That doesn't seem to make sense to dig up dirty dirt and move it somewhere else. But we also run into a situation where it's too far to landfill or it's too expensive to landfill the material. So then we actually treat it in place. So a very common thing in Alberta is you have oil contamination. So dig up the dirt and then use thermal desorption. So you basically burn the dirt. In place. You use a pug mill and then an incinerator, and you burn off the oil, and then you've got clean dirt, you can put it back. I made a conscientious effort in the early part of my career to read job advertisements and job descriptions, and to pick out the keywords, and to look, okay, what kind of courses should I get? So communication skills, okay, I took up took extra writing courses, and I worked a lot, actually, just personally, on interpersonal skills. The primary thing is to be honest with yourself. The fieldwork component, there's no getting around that. It's a very location-specific career. You will do a lot of traveling. And if you're in Alberta, that means going up north. Fort McMurray, that's where all the work is. So you have to figure out how to work with frozen fingers and stuff like that for at least 2 or 3 years. Now, be honest about what you enjoy doing, what you like doing, and what you've done well in. And build on those things. Build on your assets. And work with your defects if you have to.